everyone. Nate from Growers House here, and today we are doing the next comparison, which is our double-ended 1000-watt HPS test. And we're doing that today because Hortilux just came to market with their new double-ended 1000-watt, and we really wanted to see how it stacks up against the big players in the industry. So we brought out 8 different double-ended HPS 1000-watt bulbs, the most popular ones in the industry, and we're going to see how they do against each other. So let's check out their intensity spectrum and run some analyses on them. Let's jump into it. Okay, so here are the test results. So looking at the spectra of these different light bulbs, you'll notice that they all mirror each other extremely well. The only time you can actually notice that there's any difference in, you know, the spectra of these light bulbs is really, you know, minor differences in intensity between them at different nanometer wavelengths, but they all have the same really chemical makeup, so we expected the spectrums or the spectra of all of these to really look very similar to one another, so no surprise here. So let's move on. Now you can see, you know, how we did our testing. We essentially put the light above our 3x3 footprint, and we went out to 3x3 just because we wanted enough points to get a statistically significant, you know, total sum of PAR, which PAR is effectively the photosynthetically active radiation that the light bulb is giving off. So that's, you know, the spectrum and the intensity between 400 to 700 nanometers, which is the width of the wavelength that plants use best to photosynthesize. So in taking the sum of the intensities at all of these points within a 3x3 area, we were able to glean quite a bit of statistical data. So let me pull it up right now. So here's a chart that shows off, you know, what we think is probably the best number to focus on to figure out what lamp really did best in this test, which is the total PAR, which means taking every point that we measured and adding them all up. So when we did that, the light that turned out to give us the most amount of light using the same ballast, same reflector, was the Philips Green Power. And honestly, our hypothesis was that this lamp would probably do best because we heard from other lighting manufacturers who have done similar testing or even testing using equipment that's far superior to ours, including like gonial photometers and you know, $50,000 to $100,000 lighting instruments and things of that sort. They were saying that, you know, Philips, with some of its patented technology that they have, is really producing just about the best double-ended lamp out there. So we recorded a total PAR of 18,852, and we summed all of them up. But that said, there were 4 lights that we felt performed pretty well. I mean, that was the Philips Green Master Power being number 1, and then it looks like the Gavita Pro Plus and the Ushio, and then the Genesis. And all 4 of those lights are actually, if you add up the sum of their PARs, they're within about 1.5% of each other. So we're not talking about drastic differences. I would consider all of those bulbs very good. If you want the best bulb out there with the patent technology, probably the Philips, but it seems like the bulbs that are also, I know the Gavita and the Ushio bulb for sure are made by AULV, I think it is. I'll have to double correct that in the comments below. But that's a German company that makes a lot of really high-end double-ended lamps for quite a few companies, and I know that their lamps are known to be some of the best ones out there. I'm not sure where the Genesis is made, but it's very possible it's also made by the same factory, with maybe some minor tweaks. So that said, jumping into the lights that were not in the top 4, I mean, one of the ones that we were hoping was going to be up there, the Hortilux, didn't quite make it with their first DE iteration. And then looking into maybe what the most bang for your buck is, because I know a lot of our customers are interested in that, the Nanolux Max PAR lamp did pretty well. I believe it came just behind those first 4. And it is coming in at a cost of about 2/3 the price of most of the lamps on here, most of the ones that scored in the top 4. So that's definitely what we would call our price performer. And then, you know, the variance between all of these when we added up the sum between the best lamp and the worst lamp was about 7.36%. So I would say that's definitely, you know, you could see the difference in 7.36% in in your crop, that can be a huge difference, especially if you're on a commercial scale. That can be, you know, definitely multiple thousands of dollars, but you know, we're not talking about differences in the 10 to 20% here. So that said, I mean, this is some very interesting information, and doing this test, you know, it got us into thinking about what lamps are, you know, or how do lamps test if you test multiple of the same lamp. So we started doing that testing right now. We're going to put out another test where we're going to take like the Philips Green Power, maybe a few other lamps, and test like six of the same lamp and see what kind of tests we get, to see kind of what variance you have from bulb over bulb, so that we know whether that, you know, these percentages are extremely significant or not, or whether it could be just a little bit of chance that gives you a couple percent swing, or maybe it's just a fraction of a percent swing. Other than that, this is Nate from Growers House. Thank you very much for visiting our test. If you have any questions or comments, please give us a call or email. Have a great one. Happy growing.